Now that we've spent a little bit of time considering the key elements of inquiry-based labs and how they can align with evidence-based teaching practices, we're going to spend some time considering ways that you can assess how well your inquiry-based lab is meeting your learning goals. As with any course, you'll want to begin by considering the key features of backwards design. First, consider what you want your students to learn. Then, think about the type of evidence that will let you know how well they learn that, how well they meet those learning objectives. And then, let those decisions guide what it is you have your students do. In other words, start by identifying your learning goals and objectives, then use those to drive your assessments, and let decisions about those two determine what activities you have your students do. In this video, we're going to focus on the first two parts of backwards design. We're going to be considering how you can design or choose assessments that align well with learning objectives that are common in inquiry-based labs. We're going to start with some examples of graded summative assessments that are used in the examples of inquiry-based labs that we considered earlier, both from the astronomy inquiry-based lab and the biological sciences inquiry-based lab. Then, I'm going to share with you some examples of assessments that wouldn't necessarily be used to grade student work, to determine student grades, but that can be used in an evaluation of how well students in the lab are meeting your learning objectives. So let's start with hearing some examples of graded summative assignments that are used in those examples of inquiry-based labs that we looked at earlier.
Our overall goal in the course is to try to engage the students in becoming better thinkers through involvement in the research process. So we, in particular, we are trying to get them to figure out how to look for answers, how to determine whether what they have found is trustworthy, and to practice communicating what they've discovered and how to write up their conclusions. So within these larger goals, we have more specific objectives relating to communication. So we are trying to assess this particular objective through sessions that we have in the middle of the semester and also at the end of the semester. This involves doing a PowerPoint presentation to present the results of their work and also a poster session and a paper write-up at the end of the semester. So at the mid-semester point, each group of students does an 8 to 10 minute presentation. And in that presentation, they talk about what their goals are, their preliminary results, and any data analysis that they've done up to that point. So this is really important in the class because it's one of the main ways that the other groups in the class get to learn what the groups that they aren't involved in are doing. So they're evaluated at that point, and we have a rubric that is given to the students, and then each of the teaching personnel in the class fills out an evaluation for the group after each one of the presentations. Then the group mentor looks at those to try to arrive at a more objective way to get a grade for that presentation. At the end of the semester, then each group writes a paper and they also produce a poster. The poster is presented at a poster session that's held in the lobby of our building, and the public is invited, so a lot of the faculty will come down and see what the students have done. So the students are basically held accountable for being able to explain what happened, explain what their results mean, and in this case it's a much more one-on-one sort of experience where they interact with the questioners during the poster session. So each student, as well as each teaching personnel, goes around and fills out an evaluation of the posters, And once again, the TAs use those as a means for determining the grade that they're going to get on the poster.